Shall we get it started? Professor Saptarshi, Uma, Kanchana, shall we start it?
Yes, yeah,
of course.
I think we can start.
Professor Pillai may join due course.
Yes, that's fine. Okay, yeah. Warm welcome to all of you. Good morning. Thank you for registering. Today we are starting our Atal FTP workshop on energy conversion and storage devices. This is a 5-day workshop organized by Department of Physics, IITH. I welcome you all for this inaugural session.
Name Suresh Kumar Ratnamma, physics
faculty. Where we have this following people addressing us in the first half an hour. Professor Kanchana, who will start the proceeding with her opening remarks, is the HOD of our department. Professor Saptarshi, followed by giving inaugural remarks. Professor Saptarshi is Dean Academic of this institution. And then Professor Umashankar, who is the chair of this CCE program of IITH. This inaugural session will be followed by the inaugural lecture by Professor Pillai, whom I would invite after 5:30 onwards. Okay. So just briefly, I thought before we get it started, I'll show you our team. I don't need to tell anything about this field of energy engineering. You all know it. And within 2 days of announcement, we had all the 200 registered. Okay. And so it is a very, very popular theme and very hot topic. So I'm sure all of you who have registered are very much interested and keen to learn a lot. So this is the team which we have. Professor Pillai would get it started with his inaugural lecture on the overview of the entire field. Then we have myself, Dr. Ishwar Murthy from AIRCI, Dr. Ganapati from AIRCI, and Mr. Anil Kumar from the industry, Impulse Technology, giving talks on energy conversion devices. And Professor Dr. Martha and Maiduri, Praveen Maiduri from Chemistry and Chemical Engineering Department of IIT Hyderabad will give presentation on their lectures on the batteries. And Dr. Pratyay Basak, scientist from IICT, would give a specific talk on the electrolytes used for various battery applications. So this is the team. One important point which we thought we should have as a FDP program is a combination of the R&D as well as the industry. That's why we brought in scientists from the national labs, and also as a speaker from the industry. Mr. Anil Kumar will present on the simulations and modeling of the solar cells, LEDs, and batteries. So this is the main part. This is the 5-day program. I'm sure I have sent to all of you and you know what it is. First day today, we would have the introduction talks. Day two, day three, we concentrate on the solar cells. And then day four, day five would be on battery applications, battery fundamentals, applications, etc. One important point I should highlight here is the talk by Dr. M.P. Ganesh, who is from Liberal Arts IIT Hyderabad. He would give a presentation on teaching effectiveness and stress management. This is mandated by AICT because given the situation, given the pressures all the faculty are going through, it is important that we all are aware of what are the various stress management techniques and how to effectively teach. Okay, and then I'm sure every one of you know about the requirement of getting your AICT certificate. Atal gives you a certificate after going through this 5-day course. 80% of my attendance is mandatory, at least. And there will be an exam at the end of the 5th day on the validity section. And on that day, we have a quiz, and you should get at least 60%. 80% attendance and 60% of which will give you the certificate. Okay, attendance will be taken once in a day in any session. So we will not tell you when it is. So be online. And the quiz will be online. About 50 questions will be given, 25 each from solar cells and battery. So you'll be able to handle this. Having said this much, I would like to stop my introduction and I would pass it on to Professor Kanchana. Professor Kanchana, please.
Thank you, Santosh. So maybe it was a nice introduction. So maybe I will start it again here. Can you see my screen?
Not yet. Maybe you can share your screen altogether.
I think I have shared it.
Yeah, it is coming.
Yeah, there is
delay.
Anyway, so good morning, everyone. So as told by Santosh, I welcome you all again. Workshop, Atal FDP workshop on energy conversion and storage devices. So it's organized by Department of Physics, IIT Hyderabad. So I would like to give you a brief insight into the department and the activities going on here. So as known to everyone, Institute and the department was established in the year 2008. So we are 23 faculty members and there are 7 technical staff working with us. And we offer BTech Engineering Physics, MSc Physics and PhD Physics in our department. So you could see that the colorful photo we have, which was taken during the open day, what we used to celebrate.
Your screen is not shown. Maybe you need to click on the screen of your PPT when you're sharing. We're only seeing yours.
Oh, 1 minute. I think I have done it already. Now?
Yes. Just
yeah. Okay, fine. Yeah. So now can you see the screen which I am talking about?
Yes.
Okay, fine. Yeah. So we are offering 3 programs. So BTech EP, MSc and PhD in physics. So the research expertise, if you can see, so we are 23 faculty members who are broadly working on 4 different aspects of branches of physics, maybe the theoretical physics, computational physics, condensed matter physics experiment, optics, photonics and plasma physics. So we can see Professor Giri, Dr. Shantanu, Dr. Narendra, Dr. Shrikant, Anurag, Shubho, Priyatosh, Sandilya and Mayuk working on the theoretical physics, and I have myself, Manish, Jojit and Anupam in computational physics, and Saket, Prem, Surya, Jyoti and Arbinda in condensed matter physics, and Santosh, Vandana, Bhuvanesh, Kirit and Nityanandan, they are working on. So we have varied expertise with our department, and to be more specific into the objectives, what these groups are working on is like we have astrophysics, theoretical or phenomenological high energy physics and experimental HEP, which are being taken in the forefront by the faculties, and they mainly work on flavor physics and CP violation, quantum chromodynamics, holographic reconstruction, Gauss theory, collider physics, etc. When we look into the computational condensed matter physics, we explore mainly on materials. So to say that one of those themes would be thermoelectric materials, topological insulators, so Fermi surface properties under pressure and at extreme conditions, interfacial properties and soft matter physics. If we go to experimental condensed matter, I think my colleagues are cutting edges across various domains. So few of them would be like to explore multifunctional materials, advanced magnetic materials and devices, quantum transport in nanostructures, magnetic multilayer data storage, ultra fast magnetism, micromagnetic and atomistic simulations, and MEMS and devices. When we go to optics, we have ultrafast dynamics of atoms and molecules, femtosecond transient spectroscopy of solar cell materials, photonics and optoelectronic devices, intense laser plasma and plasma physics, and tabletop ion accelerators, and they are really extending it for medical applications, and which would really be very interesting to take it up in future. And especially the theme of the conference or the workshop is energy related, and we have Santosh and Surya already working on it, and myself also, we try to look into thermoelectric materials and predict few of the materials having good thermoelectric properties. Surya is already having an expertise in application of this magnetic materials for desensitized solar cell devices, demagnetization field driven transport, etc. Santosh is already working on solar cells and organic photovoltaic, so needless to say, you may know it. So it's not that they are just starting, so their work has really captured the attention of media, and few of the media highlights which I'm showing here into this particular slide. So this really motivates that it is high time to conduct a workshop, and I really feel that this would certainly motivate many of you attending this workshop to reach much more greater heights, and I feel that this would be a grand success. And with this much expertise in our faculties, I think this would really open up different insights and try to promote this particular field and the domain and the research pertaining to this field. And Santosh has already explained about the workshop. So this is designed at the introductory level, targeted towards the audience. So you will be the major sector who will be benefited. and who want to work in the area of energy conversion and storage. And in, we also start with the basics, as he was already telling, the first two days would be the basics, and you can try to get into that and try to go ahead with the advanced topics. So it has also contains two online lab demonstrations and one dedicated simulation sessions to supplement the theoretical concepts as well. And the goal of the course is to impart and foster knowledge in energy research and development of the state of the art approaches to shape the future of the energy applications or whatever it is. So I hope that definitely the essence of this will reach you, and I wish you all the best and have a nice time in the workshop. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Professor Kanchi. Thank you.
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah. Maybe Professor Saptarshi, the field is on.
Right. Yeah. Thanks, Santosh, for the invitation. Yeah, good morning to all the participants and my esteemed IIT Hyderabad colleagues, and also the colleagues who have joining for outside to deliver the lectures. Welcome all of you, and special thanks to our colleagues from outside IIT Hyderabad who will be delivering lectures. Thank you very much for giving your time to enrich us and the participants with your knowledge. This is Saptarshi, currently Dean Academics of IIT Hyderabad. So IIT Hyderabad, as you know, that it's only having effectively little more than 10 plus years of existence in this world. But this is a phenomenon that we are all proud of our institute, one for one reason, that within 10 years we are in the same league of our old brothers, like older IITs. We are consistently securing NIRF ranking 8, that means national ranking 8, and only 7 ahead of us are basically the old IITs. And especially when we have not even half of their strength in from anything, be it student or be it number of faculties. We have 240 faculties around roughly today's date, and 3,400 students. So we are going stronger, and in many aspects, we are the first IIT to do something. Give an example, if you talk about the first online MTech programs for working professionals, industry professionals, we have launched this year. There are a bunch of 7 online programs we have given for the industry working professionals. This is the first time in India that we are trying to take an opportunity out of a difficulty named COVID. And in this situation, we have tried to get the opportunity in terms of online programs through which we will be able to interact with industry. This is only for industry because we don't want to dilute the academics. So we are trying to get touch with them through the online programs so that industry and academia interaction remains at the highest. So IIT Hyderabad has done so many things in that way, and you know, first of its own kind. We have factor academics. That means we have our course structure is designed in such a way that you know we have introductory courses, then the depth courses. Everything is mixed in such a way so that the student can have a choice. Then you know, I want to go for some courses in introductory level. Then I can decide whether I can go for more depth or not. So we have tried to experiment, and we are not shying off experiment because we have no legacy to fear. So we are I'm proud of my colleagues, and I'm just a representative of all of them, and I'm learning from all of them, and it's fantastic experience to build an institute. So IIT Hyderabad is, we have done not only academics and teaching, we have also built an institute. We are building rather. That's a very proud moment for all of us, and frankly speaking, that the journey is just started, and we are aiming very high so that IIT Hyderabad will remain one of the best institution in India in few years from now. Coming to this workshop is very rightly posed because I was talking to my student in US who has stayed there for around 7 to 8 years, including PhD, postdoc, masters. So basically my student was saying that entire NSF funding in US as out of 100%, 80% is now focused on bio and energy research. So rest of the 20% is for other things. That is the typical statistics of NSF. And when I look back to my country, India always follows the Western countries in this regard. So here also the same thing is triggering. So if you see, the more and more funding is coming towards bio and energy. So in this context, getting such kind of workshop, which is having energy storage devices, and that with expertise that Professor Kanchana has mentioned, and it's IIT Hyderabad is rightly posed to float such kind of workshop. So thank you all for participating in this nice workshop, and it's 5-day long and with a lot of guest lectures. IIT Hyderabad is not restricting ourselves to only IIT Hyderabad, because we believe that we need to create an ecosystem, symbiotic relations with the entire other academia, so that the net effect is the something which you can elevate the standard of science and technology from the what it is today. So with all these words, I welcome you, all of you, and I thank all my colleagues who are taking the time and building this workshop and floating this workshop. And I am sure that all of you will have a wonderful time in next couple of days, and you will learn a lot of things, and you will make us learn also. And if some of you can come back to IIT Hyderabad with certain kind of projects, certain kind of collaborations, that will be the next level we can think of. Any workshop is just a nucleation. So, you know, as you know, the nucleation followed by growth for any right kinetics. So I feel that you can definitely come back to us with certain kind of more collaborations. And any point of time, IIT Hyderabad being an IIT, the T name is very important for us, the technology, for which we are remarkably different from any other institutions. At any point of time, IIT Hyderabad is having 500 projects, funded projects running, any point of time, last couple of years. So that's a very, very big thing. You can understand that way we are giving importance to the letter T. The technology is very important, and we are giving a lot of space. I'm sure this workshop will not end here. Workshop will go ahead, and we'll definitely go for the application. Some of you will be with IIT Hyderabad in a later stage. Thank you very much, all of you again. Thanks, Santosh, for your kind invitations and for having me. Thank you very much for all of
you. Thank you. Thank you, Professor Santosh. Yes. I request Professor Umesh Shankar, Chair CCE, to give his final remarks.
Thank you very much, Professor Santosh. I welcome all the participants, all the invited speakers, my colleagues, and everyone who is present here this morning, and welcome to this workshop. I myself, Umesh Shankar, I'm a professor in the Department of Civil Engineering. I am also taking care of the Center for Continuing Education at IIT Hyderabad. I'm also an advisor to National Thermal Power Corporation, NTPC. As you can see, they burn the coal and generate a lot of energy requirements for the country. And I should say that I can very much appreciate this particular workshop with the theme on energy conversion and storage devices, because I'm sure we are looking at a very environmental friendly solution, and all the deliberations that would happen in this particular topic will be of great use to everyone. And I should also say that I myself have conducted a FDP program last year. And it is not easy to conduct a 5-day-long FDP program. And I should congratulate my colleague, Professor Santosh, for doing this particular coordination, because you have to ensure that the program is very well poised in terms of how you arrange the lectures and so on. There is a lot of coordination with respect to talking to the resource persons so that they can come and present their work and share their experience. And I can see that there are very well-known speakers from different research organizations, ARCI, ICER, Impulse Technology, industry is also participating, and also a lab session is organized. So I'm sure it's going to be a wonderful workshop. And I also welcome Professor Pillai, who has been a very regular for giving invited talks at IIT Hyderabad. And I'm sure the sessions will be great. And with these few words, I would like to conclude saying that all the participants, please participate in this workshop, because this is meant for sharing the experience or sharing the research that is done in this area. Please interact with the resource persons. And I'm sure that the interaction is not going to end with a 5-day workshop. So I think it will be continuing many more months, many more years down the line. So it's very important that you start coordinating, or we start communicating with each other. I think that is the essence of having a long-term relationship in terms of research and so on. And I am sure all the resource persons will be very happy to get back to you with any questions. If your question is very reasonable and in a reasonable time, I'm sure they will be happy to answer your questions even after the workshop. So that's what I would like to say. And with these few words, as my Dean Academic Program has pointed out, we are very proud of our institute, IIT Hyderabad, and we are developing a state-of-the-art research facilities. I wish you are all here physically present, but given the situation, I think this is the way forward. But whenever the situation is getting better, whenever you get a chance, please visit our labs, because the research facilities, I am sure Santosh is going to show you, are amazing, and it will be very good if you can come and visit us. So I think with these few words, I congratulate Professor Santosh and also the Department of Physics for organizing such a workshop. I thank all the participants, all the resource persons for sparing their time. And I also thank my office here, especially Ms. Priyanka, who has been coordinating in conducting this workshop behind the scenes. And finally, thanks to AICTE for funding this workshop and facilitating such a wonderful opportunity for interacting with all of the colleagues from different universities, from different research institutes. I'm sure there are faculty members, research scholars present here. And let's have a wonderful interaction session. And with these few words, I would like to wish my colleague, Professor Santosh, all the very best. And thank you for inviting me for this particular inaugural session. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Professor Uma. Thank you for your vote of thanks and giving us a complete picture of what goes through for this DP. So I would, with your permission, I would like to conclude the formal inaugural session, and we would be happy to